Hello and what's up YouTube? So I have this problem with my CRF250L rear brake. If I have not used the bike for about a week, the brake does not work. What I will normally do is to crack open this banjo bolt using a 12mm wrench. Pump the rear pedal one time to release some brake fluid. Tighten the banjo bolt again. And just like that, the rear brake magically works again. I have been doing this for quite some time now and it is a hassle. So this time, I decided to do something about it and rebuild the brake master cylinder and fix the problem for good. So I begin this assembly by again removing the banjo bolt. I have a pan to capture the old brake fluid. Then I remove the two bolts on the master cylinder. Then I pull the hose from the brake fluid cup out so that I can remove the hose clamp using a pair of pliers. The brake fluid reservoir is, by the way, held by one bolt that I already removed earlier. Then I remove the split pin on the brake rod joint. And now the rear brake master cylinder is out of the bike, ready for servicing. I disassemble it by first breaking out this lock nut on the clevis. I remove the clevis, then the nut. This bolt has a flat spot at the end so that we can grip it with a pair of pliers. And that will enable us to remove this other nut that holds the rubber boots. Once that is removed, we can now see the internal circlip. For that, we need a circlip pliers. Once that is removed, the push rod and the piston set can be removed. I will reuse these parts, so I have to clean them well. The piston set can be pushed out from the banjo bolt hole. The rubber seals in this piston is what goes bad on this old master cylinder. It worn out or lose its elasticity. To do the repair, we need the rear master cylinder repair kit. This one right here, I bought from the motorcycle parts shop, is a generic rear brake master cylinder repair kit. It is not specific to Honda CRF250L, but it will fit several other models. The label says it fits Honda NSR, Beat, Dash, Sonic. Those are smaller displacement Honda bikes. But this kit will work with the CRF250L because Honda is using the same Nissin brand brakes on many different models. You can see that these parts are identical. So, if you cannot find a specific replacement part for Honda CRF250L, look for other Honda motorcycles with the same Nissin brakes parts. I start reassembly by thoroughly cleaning all parts that I will reuse. I measure the bore on the master cylinder to make sure that it is not more than 12.76 mm in internal diameter. As you can see on the master cylinder body, it says 1/2. That is the bore size, 1/2 inch, and is equivalent to 12.7 mm. Moving on to the assembly, I insert the piston with the spring towards the banjo bolt hole. I just lubricate all internal parts with WD-40. Then the nut onto the new rubber boots. I struggle at this one at first, then I realize it will be easier if I screw the nut to the push rod. Give me something to hold on to, and it goes in there a lot easier. Putting the circlip, it can be tricky because we need to push the rod in to expose the circlip groove. The way I do it is to hold the master cylinder body with my left hand. I push the rod with my thumb, then I insert the circlip I had on the pliers in my right hand. I used a small flat screwdriver to push it to the grooves. You will hear a click when it finally falls in place. Before moving further, I want to test if the new piston is working. So I pressed the push rod against the table while covering the hole with my finger and feel if it is building up pressure. That confirms that the piston is okay. Next, I screw in the nut with the rubber boot. Then, push in the edges of the rubber boots. Some will put grease on the push rod inside the rubber boot. I use a pair of pliers to grip the flattened end of the push rod so that I can tighten this nut. After that, it is just the 8mm lock nut and the clevis or the brake rod joint. And I am ready to put this newly rebuilt rear brake master cylinder back to the bike. I start by inserting the hose from the brake fluid reservoir and fixing the hose clamp in place. Then, attach the brake master cylinder to the frame with two bolts. Then install the banjo bolt with the two washers. I reused the old washers and I did not have any problem with leaks. You may want to adjust the play of the brake pedal, and you can do that by adjusting the brake rod joint and the lock nut. Then install the brake joint pin and split pin. I already lost the original split pin and I'm just using a piece of wire instead. Next is the classic procedure of bleeding the brakes. I did not bother with the hose on the bleeder screw. I just put a pan to catch the brake fluid. With the bleeder screw closed, pump 3 times on the brake pedal and hold it in the depressed position. Open the bleeder screw briefly to let air and fluid escape and close again. Then pump the brake pedal again. Do these steps repeatedly until all the air has been bled out from the system. And the brake feels solid. Don't forget to refill the fluid as necessary. It is easier to bleed the rear brake because it has shorter hose and therefore less volume where air can get trapped in. My CRF250L is kind of a Frankenstein bike. You will see a different rear wheel and muffler. After bleeding all the air out, I just wiped the excess fluid that spilled. I did not have any problem with brake fluid ruining the paint job. I reattached the bleeder screw cap. I top up the brake fluid. I put on the diaphragm and cap. And reinstall it to the bike. And that's about it. Very easy. Anyone with simple tools can do it. Thank you for watching, and I hope that you subscribe to my channel.